I am Kunwar Rajkumar Singh, Rathod. Welcome to Fly Rajputs Towards Infinity. And today's question is, draw a cycloid given the dia of a generating circle is 50 mm. So for drawing a cycloid, one data is sufficient, which is the dia or the radius of the generating circle. So in this question, they have provided us the dia of the generating circle, which is 50 mm. So with the help of this data, we can easily draw the cycloid. So the first step is draw the circle. Okay, this is the circle of a dia 50 mm, and then mark a point P which is in the contact to the surface and draw a line. Extend this line up to Q such that the length of the line should be pi d, which is the perimeter of the circle, pi d. D is the diameter of the circle. So this is how you can calculate the perimeter and draw the line of the same length. Now mark the center of the circle. Okay, and divide this circle into 12 equal parts. I have just drawn one horizontal and one vertical line, and now to draw to divide this circle into 12 equal parts, we can use the trial and error method. So we will cut an arc here and here, and using this thing. So this is how we can divide a circle into 12 equal parts. They are not exactly equal, but because it is very rough on the board, so you have to draw it very accurately using the right equipment. So mark these points, name this point as 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, and 12. Okay. Now divide PQ into same number of equal parts, which is 12. Okay. So we will use the same method we earlier used for drawing the diagonal scales. Okay. Cut this line into 12 equal parts. Cut 12 equal arcs. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, and 12. And now join the last point to the end point of the line and draw parallel lines from each point. And name them 1 dash, 2 dash, 3 dash, 4 dash, 5 dash, 6 dash, 7 dash, 8 dash, 9 dash, 10 dash, 11 dash, and 12 dash. So this is how we can divide a line into 12 equal number of parts. Okay. Now draw horizontal lines from each point on the circle. And extend them Okay, and then draw perpendicular lines to PQ. And to draw perpendicular lines, I will use this. Draw perpendicular lines such that it will intersect line C, line passing through C. C is the center or the locus of the circle. Okay, so this line C will be the locus of the circle. And name these points as C1, C2, C3, C4, C5, C6, C7, C8, C9, C10, C11 and C12. Okay, now next step is take radius of the circle as the radius and C1, C2, C3 as centers and cut arc on the consecutive lines. Like firstly take this much, the radius of the circle as radius and C1 as center, and cut an arc on the line 1, line passing through 1. So this will be over here. Okay, and this point will be P1, our point on the required cycloid. And next, take again the radius of the circle as radius and C2 as center, and cut another arc on line passing through point 2. It will give us the point P2. Repeat this step to get more points. Again, now C3, Q3, P3, C4, P6, here we go, P5, P4, and somewhat here, P12, P9, P10, and P11. So, this is how we can get the required number of points and join all these points with a smooth curve to get the required cycloid. So, the curve is the locus of point P. As the point travels along the line, it will go till here. Okay, so this is the locus of the point P, which is nothing but the cycloid. Okay, you have to draw it very accurately on your drawing sheet, as it is on the whiteboard, so it is not exact and not accurate. So this is how you can draw a cycloid using this method, in which you required only one data, which is the radius or the dia of the generating circle. So if you like the content, then please click on the like button, do share this video to all your colleagues, and don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Thanks for watching.